गुड इवनिंग. डिसम्बर ऑलवेज होल्ड्स अ वेरी स्पेशल प्लेस इन माई हार्ट. सिंस चाइल्डहुड इट वॉज समथिंग. दिस इज़ द मंथ, द ईयर एंड दैट आई वुड लुक फॉरवर्ड टू, बिकॉज डिसम्बर मेंट क्रिसमस हॉलीडेज, डिसम्बर मेंट ग्रेट वेदर, डिसम्बर मेंट माई फादर्स बर्थडे ऑन 25th ऑफ डिसम्बर, एंड इट वुड ऑल्सो मीन माई कजन्स कमिंग ओवर, और वी ऑल टुगेदर विद कजन्स गोइंग अवे समवेयर फॉर अ शॉर्ट वेकेशन. And the Christmas tree, the gifts exchanged, the stories that we shared with each other, the games that we played, the artwork that we did, all of this is December for me. So among all these things, the one aspect of December that I really miss and it stands out in my life is the part of storytelling. So yes, the Christmas holidays were a time where one of my uncles, Mr. Pradeep Ghosh, he used to tell us stories, and they were not stories just related to Christmas. They were just stories which, from all kinds of stories, from ghost stories to motivational stories, and especially he really told the ghost stories very well. So he would set up a complete mood, and it would be a dark room, and then with a torch on the book, he would tell us the story. So I thought that on 1st of December, let me try giving back something that I have received in such great quantity. So from my uncle, I have learned many stories, and there was also my aunt. She used to put me to sleep every evening, every night by telling a story, and this happened 365 days in a year. So I didn't go to sleep as a child till my aunt told me a story, and it had to be a new story. So dedicated to all the great storytellers, here is a beautiful story that I wish to narrate. Since we are talking about Christmas and December, I feel that it would be great to listen to or read a story which is about Jesus. And mystically, this morning, since the last couple of days, I have been drawn to the figure of Mary Magdalene. It's not that my association with Mary Magdalene goes back almost 14-15 years. I have always, she's a very mysterious character in Bible traditions in Christianity, and she is very fascinating for me. So this morning also, I have since morning, I have been drawn to Mary Magdalene quite a bit, and I feel as if she's watching over me. Perhaps she is. So that's why I decided to also keep a little surprise at the end of the story. So let me begin first, and it is from this book called Blue Lotus, and it's a collection of stories from across the world, and it has been compiled by the author Meena Arora Nayak. So she has written this book, and she has included stories from across the world. So this book is something which I intend to read out to you from through this month, and there will be other books as well, and I'd love to hear your suggestions. So this particular story is called Resurrection of Jesus. Very early on Sunday, the morning after they had laid Jesus in the tomb, Mary, the mother of Jesus, Mary of Magdala or Mary Magdalene, Joanna, and some of the other women brought spices that they had prepared for his body to keep it from emitting the smell of death. At the entrance to the tomb, they were surprised to see that the rock which kept the tomb closed had been rolled away. And when they went inside, they discovered that Jesus' body was gone. Utterly at a loss about what to do next, they stood staring at the empty spot, when two shining men suddenly appeared at their side. The women became afraid and started to back away, but the men spoke. "Why are you searching among the dead for him who lives? Remember what he told you at Galilee, that he was the Son of Man. Remember, he said he must be sacrificed for the sins of men and be crucified, but he will rise again on the third day." The women remembered. They hurriedly left the tomb and went to tell the apostles what they had seen and heard. But the apostles didn't believe them. That same day, two apostles on their way to the village of Emmaus, which lay about 7 miles from Jerusalem, were talking about all these strange happenings, when Jesus himself joined them and began walking alongside. But for some reason, they didn't recognize him. "What are you talking about?" he asked them. They stopped and looked bleakly at the man who had posed this question. Then Cleopas answered, "You're probably the only person in Jerusalem who doesn't know what has happened in the last few days." "What do you mean?" Jesus asked. "Did you not hear about Jesus of Nazareth?" they replied. "He was a prophet of speech and action, empowered God and all the people. He was crucified. Our own priests gave him up and they sentenced him to death. He was our hope for liberating Israel. This was 3 days ago, and then women we know gave us the astounding news that his body has disappeared from the tomb. But they saw two angels there who told them that he is alive. Some of us went to the tomb to check. Everything seemed to be exactly as it should be, but Jesus' body is definitely gone. Why are you so reluctant to believe that what the prophet said?" Jesus asked. "It is not that the Messiah will suffer before he attains glory. Is it not said that the Messiah will suffer before he attains glory?" Then he explained to them passages from the scriptures that made references to Jesus. When they reached the village, Jesus bid the men farewell and turned to go on his way. But the two apostles stopped him. "Why don't you stay with us today? The sun has gone down and it'll be dark soon." Jesus agreed and went with them to the house in which they were staying. Later that night, when they sat at the table and Jesus broke bread with a blessing and passed it to them, their eyes opened and they recognized him. But at that moment, he vanished. The men became excited. "We know in our hearts," they exclaimed. "The way he explained the scriptures, we felt him in our hearts." Right away, they left for Jerusalem, where the apostles were assembling. When they heard that the Lord had appeared to Simon, they described their own meeting with him and how they did not recognize him until he broke bread. Then, even as they were talking, Jesus was among them again. Seeing him, the apostles drew back in fear, thinking he was a ghost. And Jesus said to them, "Don't look disturbed. Believe what you see. Why do you question this? Here, look at my hands and feet. Touch me and see for yourself that I am no ghost. I am flesh and bone." When they still hesitated, he asked them if they had anything to eat. They gave him a piece of fish and he ate it before their eyes and said, "I told you about this when I was still with you, that whatever is written about me in the scriptures will come true. It is written that the Messiah will suffer for the sins of men and be put to death. But he will rise from the dead on the third day to forgive them for their sins and liberate them. That day has come. You are witnesses of this. Now go forth and proclaim this message to all the people in all the nations." Myth from the New Testament. So this is the first story that I have shared with you today, and I hope to bring you many more new stories, stories which you may have heard and stories which you may not have heard. And if you have any suggestions of books that I should refer to, or if any short story has interested you, do send it to me, do give me your feedback. And any of you who are into writing stories and would like me to share your story, please send it to me, get in touch with me, and I hope I'll be able to do justice to it. So as I said, that after this storytelling, I will have a little surprise for you. So the surprise is this oracle deck, which is Mary Magdalene's oracle. an ocean of eternal love. So I got this deck about a year back, but I got to kind of use it just this month, and I found the deck really mystical, and it meant that it, and I, while I played with the cards, tried to get familiar with the energy, I feel that this deck has a lot to say and it speaks to my soul. So from this deck, I will pick one card which is energetically something that we all share, the energy that we've just shared. So from that, I'm going to read out one card, and those of you who are watching me, you can just put in a question in your mind, just have it in your intention, a question if you have any, and when I draw the card, see if it answers your situation or it gives you a perspective to your situation. So as I shuffle the card, please have a question in mind, and let's see what it holds for you. So I'll pick the card which is right at top of the deck, and it says Gaia. So this card has been it's a card of Mother Earth, and it has been coming up in my reading quite a few times, not only from this deck but from the others as well. And it says, whether male or female, you are advised to embrace your feminine side. So let me also tell you something, that for the last few days I've been hearing the divine feminine, these two words have been coming up in various ways in a lot of things. So perhaps it's a sign from the universe. So it says that embrace your feminine side. This means embracing your intuitive, gentle and loving nature and applying these qualities to a current troublesome situation. Embracing these nurturing and gentle qualities will help you to feel a great sense of balance, and this will help you overcome your present difficulty. So bring in a lot of love and compassion to the situation that you are going through. Ask Mother Earth to help you ground and strengthen you, and you will feel a renewed sense of vitality. So if you are into meditation today, just while we are talking, while we are reading this card's meaning, just touch your feet to the ground and feel the strength of the earth coming up to you. So imagine that your legs, your feet is connecting with the earth, like roots connect to the earth. Get that hold of the earth and believe the energy of the earth is rising into your body through the roots. And it will also be good if you spend some time in nature. It's already night, but you can do that tomorrow morning as well, or you can just look at the night sky and feel the cool winter breeze and see what the universe has to tell you. Feel your connection to the earth and remember that both masculine and feminine qualities are complementary parts of every human being. Balance through power and wisdom are only possible when you embrace both. And there is this little couplet. For years I have felt your yearning, forever I have loved you. For years I have felt your yearning, forever I have loved you. And you can repeat it to yourself once more while you're watching this. For years I have felt your yearning, forever I have loved you. So if you found this card reading useful, or you have any questions, you can all reach out to me, and maybe I can also do a little card reading for you, a customized special card reading for you. So just let me know, and if you please send me stories that you have liked, and I can then perhaps read it out to you. So I'm really glad that so many of my friends have been watching this. Thank you, Ditya. Thank you, Ipo, and whoever else took out the time to see this. Thank you so much, and I hope to be with you again tomorrow. And I'm not sure whether this will be the same time, but somewhere around evening I should be with you. Take care and have a very good evening. Do spend some time looking at the sky today. Thank you.